Our first speaker tonight is one of our current members. It's Carol Nischik. Now, when I think about Carol, I think less about communication and more about leadership, because I think that Carol, I think Carol embodies the leadership strand of this organisation. We at Toastmasters spend a lot of time thinking about communication, but it's only possible to be effective communicators if people are able to lead our clubs. And my definition of a leader is somebody who gets people to do things that they don't want to do. And I think that as Vice President of Education, or even he is recording for example, over a period of a year, Carol got so many people to do so many things that they didn't want to do. And I tell you what, they were all really happy when they did it. So it showed that leadership, I think, is about getting people to do things that then later they're very proud of achieving. So in that vein, I was particularly pleased that Carol decided that he was going to do a speech that's, okay, communication, but also related to leadership. And to his favourite topic, of course, a little bit of history, because one thing we know about Carol is he loves his history. So I need to take you all back. You're all in 1978. Think about the flares and the flower power era. If you're in Britain, we're back at that. Difficult times. And around the world, there are problems, and people realise that there's going to be some tough economic times ahead. Sounds a bit like today. So you're going to have to make some difficult decisions. And you are about to meet Lee Iacocca, who, after working his whole career at Ford, is now moving to the Chrysler Corporation. Chrysler is on the verge of bankruptcy. Anybody knows the idea there? And his job is to turn the company around. To do so, he's got to motivate his senior and middle managers, also his union representatives, in order to make some difficult changes. And who are those people? Well, they're you. You and your flares, your nice captains and so forth, you are all going to be middle or senior managers of Chrysler Corporation back in 1978, and you're all going to find out what it is that you're going to have to do for the future. So, with a speech entitled, rather intriguingly, Hannibal at the Gates, please help me to welcome Carol Nischik, better known as Lee Iacocca.
Chief Executive Officer of Chrysler Corporation. I've spent all of my professional life at Ford, serving past 8 years since 1970 as President of Ford Motor Company. But the ways of me and Mr. Henry Ford II split, and now I'm leading Chrysler Corporation. I have two news for you, a good one and a bad one. The bad news is that we are on the verge of bankruptcy. We are losing money, our sales plummets, and for the first quarter of the year, we reported a loss of $160 million, the biggest in our history. The good news is, however, that from now on, things can only get better. We're in hell right now, believe me, and we can stay here, get the shit kicked out of us, and we can climb our way back into the light. We can climb out of hell. As some of you know, my family comes from Italy, once a glorious Roman Empire. But before Rome, Roman Republic became an empire, it has to face many challenges along the way. And one of these challenges almost destroyed it. In 280 BC, Carthaginian Hannibal Barca crossed Alps and invaded Italy. He destroyed each and every Roman army they sent against him. At Ticinus, at Lake Trasimene, at River Trevi. But the worst was yet to come. In 216 BC, at Cannae, Hannibal virtually annihilated that Roman army of 80,000 men and slaughtered all of them on one day. On one day, Rome lost more men than the United States in the entire Vietnam War. After that, he thought he won. He sent an envoy to the Roman Senate, but to his surprise, they refused to negotiate. They sent an envoy without talking to him, because they knew it was too much at stake. There, simply, for them, losing is not an option, as far as they're concerned. They either win it all or be destroyed. And what Hannibal didn't knew, the new hard-won state of mind was emerging, epitomized by their new leader Scipio. And Scipio demanded they stay strong, to keep going and keep on fighting. Desperate times calls for desperate measures. First, Rome needs to rebuild its armies. The old rules of who could join the legions were relaxed. Boys were the family said. Slaves were promised freedom. Criminals and debtors were promised amnesty if they signed up. War tax was doubled, and no one complained. And what is also striking is that it was not just the aristocratic leaders that insisted on fighting, but all the citizens felt that it was that they had a say of what's going on. As the story goes, Rome defeated Hannibal, they burned Carthage to the ground, and built an empire. This story reminds the situation that we are today. There is Hannibal at our gates. We are losing money. We are losing sales to importers from Japan, which have fuel-efficient smaller cars. In recent years, the price of gas doubled, which is particularly bad for Chrysler, because we are leader in gas guzzling utility vehicles. We and the last two models we put on the market, Plymouth Valerian and Aspen Voyager, are a mess that goes to a mechanic more often than a drunk person goes to the toilet. Well, I know all that, but I know that Chrysler has a respectable past, but I also believe it has a future. We already prepared a plan, a three-point plan on our way to redemption. The blood first. The blood of every company is cash, and we are losing it and are desperate need of it. Next week, I'm going to Washington, D.C. to speak before the Congress, because we need a government loan guarantee for $1.2 billion. I know it's controversial. I know that our competitors will complain that it's against free competition, but it's our only chance of survival. I will convince them, because for once, I made research, and back a few years ago, government already supported Lockheed, electric, and railroad companies. Second of all, I already prepared printouts for each and every congressman with a list of dealers and suppliers who cooperate with us and who will also go down if we go down, so that the congressmen would know what would be the consequences for their regions if we are to fund. And third of all, I will give them simple offer that they can refuse. They either pay $2.7 billion in unemployment benefits just the first year, or they will grant us a loan for $1.2 billion with a strong chance that they will get it all back. Once we get money, we need to become cost efficient, because we, at the moment, we're not. Desperate times calls for desperate measures. There will be massive layoffs, pay cuts, and closing plants. We're gonna close our plants in Europe. I will start, as far as salary is concerned, I'll start with myself. For the next year, my salary is $1. Every person in management and in corporate headquarters will get a pay cut, except for secretaries, who I believe they deserve every cent they get. As far as blue-collar workers are concerned, I know you are good people, working hard to feed your families so your children can go to college. I understand it. My father worked in a factory. So with a very heavy heart, I have to say that some of you have to be let go. And for those of you who stay, I've got thousands of jobs at $17 an hour, but I have no at 20. There will be no strikes, no negotiations. You either take it or we all hit the bricks. When we get cash, we are cost efficient, it's time to strike back, and strike back hard. We have the world's top engineers already working on the new models of fuel-efficient cars, like K-cars and minivans. Once they're ready, we're going to start a nationwide marketing campaign. Already, the days and nights, our marketing team works on a public relations campaign, so we regain customers' trust. listen that we're not that American. We do not feel that. And remember that night is always darkest just before the dawn. And when the dawn comes, there will be time for bonuses, raises, and promotions. I can promise you that. So let's get back to work, roll up our shirt sleeves. It's time to show the world what we made of.